This question belongs to data structure subject and was asked in GATE CSE 2014 set 2. So the question states, consider the tree arcs of a BFS traversal from a source node W in an unweighted connected undirected graph. The tree T formed by the tree arcs in a data structure for computing. The shortest path between every pair of vertices. The shortest path from W to every vertex in the G. The shortest path from W to only those nodes that are leaves of T, the longest path in the graph. So suppose we have a graph like this. We have node A, node B, node C, node D, node E, node this, F. We have a graph like this. So BFS will start from any vertex. So let us suppose we start from vertex A. So what it will do, next, then it will go to all its neighbors. So A will go to B, C and F. B is neighbor, C is neighbor and F is neighbor. Now B will go to its neighbor, it will go to E, A is already done. Now C will go to its neighbor D and F, let us suppose G is also here, F will go to G. Now tree edges are the edges which are present in the BFS traversal. Now, the tree can be used for computing. See, we know that BFS will go to its all its adjacent nodes and then it will go to its adjacent. See, the path from A to G can go through A, C, D, E, F, G. But there is another path, A, F, G, and this path is present in the BFS traversal. It will start from a one node and find the shortest path. So, BFS traversal, shortest path to every vertex in the graph from W. So answer is option B. It do not find between every pair of vertices because it has a source, only one source. So it find the shortest path from W to every other vertex in the graph. And not only to the leaves because E is also a leaf and there are two paths of length 3 and length 2, but it finds the shortest path of length 2 and not the longest path for sure. So correct answer is option B.